Like, every individual decides what he's going to do, whether it's on his own or collectively. Like, if we all say, like, I use the example of some maniac keeps driving through a town at 90 miles an hour drunk every night. We don't want to kill him. And let's say some of us said, let's put up a roadblock and stuff. Like, he's actually, like, obvious endangerment. There, you know, he's flying down this little town road at 90 and swerving around. And let's say a bunch of people, not everybody, a bunch of people say, look, this is way too much of a hazard. We're going to set up a roadblock. When he stops, because he has to, because he'll crash into it, we're going to take him out of his car and we're going to drive his car into the lake. Because he's literally doing 90 down our little road. And a bunch of the rest of the town says, woo, that's sort of overkill. Yeah, I'm glad you stopped him, but that... The thing is, you don't have to all agree. Like, that doesn't determine the outcome. But we're never all going to agree.
But what happens when the guy takes his car and throws it in the
lake? See, that's the thing. I'm getting there. It's a concept I call social equilibrium, where you get to the point where everybody goes, well, I don't feel the need to use violence against anybody. So let's say this guy kept doing it. Every night he's driving through, and then a bunch of people stop him driving his car into the lake. And a bunch of the other people say, well, we think that was bogus and overboard, but oh well. Then you're back to equilibrium, even if they didn't
approve. What if they don't say, oh well? What if they say, you know what, we shouldn't allow that kind of violence. This guy committed criminal damage on
the
other
side. Then that happens.
But then what do we do?
Whatever they do. That's the thing, is when you're trying to describe a thing, like, here's the decider, and here's the people.
Don't we want to publish what the rules are in our community? Don't we want to say, if you speed through our streets at 90 miles an hour at night, we're going to take your car and throw it in the lake.
That's funny, because I use that exact same example with this exact same example. There is no such thing as the rules being legitimate because somebody wrote them down. The only value in a rule like that is a threat to inform somebody. If you drive 90 miles an hour down a road, we're going to take your car and throw it in the lake. That doesn't make it okay that we do that. It doesn't make it legitimate. It's just us informing you what we think we already have
but
the right to do.
That's part of the due process that you're talking about. You have a right to know what the rule is in the community.
But hang on a sec. That's not the case now or in any other system. They're like, you can't write rules for every possible conceivable situation.
You can't. But
so that happens now. How do we deal with it now?
No, but we do the best we can.
To that.
We do, like, for example, just sticking with the rule, the example I gave. In Arizona, you don't get to shoot somebody because they're stealing your TV. We're letting everybody know, if Ernie shoots you because you're stealing the TV, then we're gonna grab him, we're gonna give him a trial on murder. But that might not be the rule. In another community, they may say, hey, we like the deterrence effect for thefts. And so in this community, you get to shoot
people.
And
we chop off hands.
Right. But don't we need to figure out in the community which rule we're gonna go with?
No, we don't.
Well, then when Ernie shoots somebody for stealing the TV, he's at peril. He says, in my community over here, that's perfectly fine.
Yeah.
I didn't know you guys are going to try me for murder.
And the thing is, there's actually, on a practical level, there's a benefit to that when you don't know what's going to happen to you if you do something nasty to harm somebody else.
Not when Ernie's TV's being stolen and he's got his hand on his gun because he needs to know if he can shoot or not.
But the first of all, the way you phrase it, you can't shoot someone, that's not true. No, you can shoot someone. You aim a gun at them and you pull a trigger and a bullet comes out.
What I mean is
the state will hurt you.
But
if
why
you
does
do.
It have to be the state? Forget about the state for a second.
Because
we've agreed we're going to give him a trial.
Because when you talk in, basically, when you talk in the authoritarian terms of you're not allowed to do that, instead of the literal terms of if you do X, these people are going to do this to you. So in Arizona, if he shoots someone for stealing his TV, agents of the state will come and put him in a cage. That's the reality. The reality is not you can't do it.
Forget the state. It's our anarchist society.
Yeah, but okay. In an anarchist society, the description is not you can't do that. Obviously, you can do that. You can chop people's head off with an axe.
Here's what we're going to do to you if you do.
But we don't need a we. We don't all need to agree on what the result is going to be, and we never will all agree.
Then Ernie's at risk of peril.
No,
yes.
No, it's up to him to decide for himself what to do and own the consequences of whatever happens.
Yeah,
he has to make the judgment call for himself and be able to
say, let me ask this,
I'm
going to
own whatever
what's
the
so
backlash
horrible
is
about
from.
Letting Ernie know in advance and letting Max know in
I'm
advance.
I'm in favor of that.
That in our world, if you steal somebody's TV, we're going to shoot and kill you.
The only part I don't like is the we. The only rational, moral threat is, if you do this, I feel justified. Engaging. There is no we. We don't have any rights. We aren't anything. We
right.
are a description of
Ernie,
a collection of individuals.
It's the protection company that we've hired.
Then you can say that protection company.
Where Skousen was going was a really dangerous place with the HOA Association. right? Because what happens with, see, we want to tend to agree with the HOA concept. We say, well, we've all moved in our community. In our community, we've decided we're going to hire this protection agency, and these are the rules about speeding 90 miles an hour, and these are the rules, blah, blah, blah. But I'm okay with that. You're okay with that, right?
I want
to
hear this.
Yeah, on a practical level, I think it's sort of stupid to agree to rules that haven't been written yet. Which
no, they're writing them.
Yeah, but they change them.
Yeah,
they're
getting ready
to it's like, I agree to the Homeowners Association rules, and they can change them after
well,
I agree.
But that's
I
part
think
of what you've agreed to as well. Either
I know.
We agree
like,
they can be changed
it's
or not.
Like, you have the right to voluntarily choose to do that. I just think it's stupid to say, I will abide by your rules even when you make up new ones tomorrow. I think
but,
that's
but
a dumb
that's,
thing
you,
to volunteer
So you just contract differently. You say you might say these are the rules and we're not making any new ones. These are the rules and only Ernie gets to decide if there's new ones. These are the rules and anybody can
So my objection to Homeowners Association is when you join a thing and you don't know what the rules will be tomorrow, it's kind of dumb to say, I have promised to abide by rules when I don't even know what the frig they are.
Well,
and that's why Homeowners Associations become little tyrannies.
But you agree to the mechanisms. Or you know, if I
yeah,
was,
I think it's just dumb that people do that. They have the right to do it. It's just dumb.
Right.
It's like signing a contract. I agree to whatever you tell me I have to do tomorrow.
But,
like, why
but I might
want
to say, look, you can't have a loud party after 3 a.m. That's the rule. I'll agree not to have a loud party after 3.
You you missed the point that he made. The point is that not only are you agreeing to whatever the rules are, you're agreeing to them arbitrarily changing the rules if I got a majority of I rule you now.
You might just simply say, these are all the rules they'll ever shall be.
Give me that option.
But you may also say, we can change the rules by 100% unanimous.
Well, they had kind of promised that. It was called the Constitution.
No, the Constitution doesn't say that. But I'm not defending the Constitution.
But if you're talking about consensus rules where all of us have to agree to a change, that's fine. Because then it isn't a matter of, I agree to your rules, and then you change the rules to say that you're allowed to kill anybody with red hair.
That's just the flavor of an HOA that you like. Some people might say, I'm okay with him changing the rules.
Yeah.
Or him changing, whatever,
and it's
but
sort of, you know,
okay.
It's the same thing I bash voluntary socialism for. Like, you have every right to voluntarily do that arrangement. It's going to suck, but you have every, like, I'm not going to forcibly stop
you. I agree
with
you, but I don't even go and say it's going to suck, because some people like the idea of, you know, from each according to his ability to each according to his
ability. And I just say economically it's not going to work, but I'm not going to stop you.
But that may not be the goal. Maybe they have some religious, you know, whatever. I don't know.
But right? I mean, but that, I'm just saying,
so
it's the difference between
want,
that's
right.
immoral and evil and me just saying,
right.
You can
so
do that
if
you want,
you
but
there,
I would.
If we get you there, and I think we're both at the same place, what's so dangerous about the Marc Skousen argument with the HOA is he turns in the United States into a giant homeowners association.
Right, and suddenly we agree to the rules
right,
by falling out of our moms.
Yes, the difference is what I say is real consent.
Yeah.
That's the key. If you have real consent to the HOA, then I think it's okay.
Yeah.
If you don't have real consent, then just sort of saying we're going to drop this on you is bad.
Yeah.
But I don't see any problem, and I think there's going to be lots of needs for communities to come together. Like, for example, the self-defense thing I mentioned. I give an example all the time in my crowd about the three-year-old girl's bouncy ball bounces across your front yard, and the homeowner comes out and blows her away because it's a trespass. He says, hey, I'm acting as a good libertarian. She shouldn't have trespassed. The rest of us may say, we didn't quite like that conduct. He says, why not? We say, well, because you pulled out your AR-15 and blew away the five-year-old girl because she trespassed in your front yard. He says, well. So at some point, we probably want to say there needs to be a reasonableness requirement with self-defense. Oh, there needs to be a reasonableness requirement. What's reasonable? So
right,
we need
but
to sit down and talk about that.
Yeah, but that's still just sort of voicing your own warning to other people of what
that's
you
what
will and won't feel justified
that's
yourself
what it is.
In doing.
So
see, the risk of we, the reason that the word we makes me want to have a tantrum, is because as soon as there's a we, people stop feeling like they have to feel personally responsible. Like, well, we voted that the rich guy should be robbed and we get some of the money, instead of I feel personally justified. When the responsibility is on the individual, look, if you think that you, on your own, as a normal human being, no badge, no legislation, no nothing, have the right to drive that guy's car into the lake, then you might do that. And other people might say, don't do that or we'll do this.
So the guy
so
who
hang
the
on, I think we can, we're just talking, you're talking past each other here. There's a small little bit. You're just really object to the word we.
Well,
but the
idea that we ever has rights that have, have something other to do with than the individual
yes,
rights.
The phrasing that Marc could use to achieve the same thing is, do I or do I not subscribe to an organization to throw the guy's car in the lake or go and get the guy who shot the five-year-old girl.
Yeah, and
okay,
yeah,
now,
and that's
now what happens is somebody who hasn't subscribed to our group, right, comes through and does something that violates our rules. he chops off somebody's head, he shoots a little girl, and under his scheme of the world, he's perfectly fine. He says, hey, look, somebody trespassed on me, and I get to shoot her under my scheme. And we say, well, in our community, you don't get to shoot a five-year-old girl because she chases her bouncy ball. So I'm going to want to drag them into the criminal justice system at
right.
that point.
Yeah, but
and all I'm saying to you, Larken, is this. I'm against coercion. I think we might be stuck with it in a couple little areas like the justice system.
Right,
and
you can find
like,
gray areas.
Right, would you shoot Hitler in the head before, you know, there's some
right.
examples. But so I want to keep it as really, really, really minimum as possible. But I don't see anything horrible in voluntary association between people who accept the non-aggression principle to try to set out some rules that are not answered by the non-aggression principle, like the remedies that are to be used for a trespass.
It'll be exactly the same as it was with the government, with the state system. Because there are going to be rules.
Yes.
And there'll be rules voluntarily entered into by association.
Yes.
You'll subscribe to this DRO, you can call it, or a protection agency. You'll subscribe to that one. And there's a conflict amongst the protection agencies. And while, like, let's say, for example, the death penalty is a good one. This organization over here has a million subscribers, a million paying customers that says, we're going to seek the death penalty for anybody
mm-hmm.
who murders you. This one over here says, we're not going to seek the death penalty.
Right.
Now, this one has a million customers. This one has 500,000 customers. And they do it some math and say, we're going to lose X number of customers for not following through on this. We're going to lose X amount of customers for not following through on our perspective. That DRO is going to have to, one of the DROs are going to have to bribe each other to forego and break their promises to their customers.
Or said another way, somebody's
like
going to impose their rules on the other at some point.
But I don't think it will be via force. It will be via economics. And it will turn into a voting with your money type scenario. If you're going to violate the promise to your customers by not getting the death penalty and not shooting someone who was found guilty of the crime because he had a DRO and a huge defense organization to defend him and promised to only give him life in prison for that, then if this company secures life instead of a death penalty, they're going to have to compensate that DRO.
I understand, and it sounds very reasonable to me, but what I'm saying is...
Tony, the next point answers your question, I promise. So you have these laws, they start off quite basic at the beginning, but over time, in exactly the same way in our current situation, this body of precedent builds up
yes,
and builds up and
absolutely.
Builds up. And there's lots of things that there were not precedents for until there were precedents for.
Yeah.
And eventually,
common
through time, you learn whether or not you can shoot the five-year-old
perfect.
Girl.
Perfect. That's what I'm talking about.
Okay.
What I'm saying is the non-aggression principle probably resolves 95% of disputes in society, right? But what is coercion exactly? We'll disagree on that,
mm-hmm.
right? Is it coercion? Is it strong persuasion, right? At some point, I can get everybody here to disagree on where we cross the line into coercion from persuasion. There's no right answer to that.
Right.
What we need to establish is some sort of precedent for how we're going to deal with it, because later on, you got to know, am I engaging in coercion now under the rules in this community, or am I still in the persuasion realm? You got to know in advance. That's part of the due process thing. So if you come to this community, we might have different rules than the last community about where the line between persuasion and coercion is. And it's that area that I think we're going to need to get together, and as I said in my speech, the voluntary association of free people, or whatever we want to call it.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to call it the big scary G word or the state or anything like that. But at some point, we need to get together and come up with rules that we think give notice to people about how we interpret the non-aggression principle. And that's all I'm saying.
Okay, I want to have a comment here.
Tell me where I got it wrong.
No, you keep the we thing, and the reason that I'm...
We're not islands, Ernie.
No, the point is that the chaos that is the threat of people just acting as individual agents to do whatever, there's going to be chaos. We're not going to know which kind.
How do we resolve
this question? I go, as compared to what? I mean, you go, Ernie, you're such an anarchist. I go, compared to what? What we got now? So the thing is that I see the sickness of the idea of there is an authority or a lab coat or a badge or a gun with a fine hat and a clipboard and so on. That mentality right there doesn't allow for the equilibrium of the chaos to even find a medium. It doesn't allow. It's much more robust, much more consistent, much more, it can take the hits, it can adopt to all kinds of new different situations. if people are allowed in an anarchist society to do that. Yes, there will be all kinds of rules and cultures and things in this neighborhood and on that side of the street, and all that will develop naturally if allowed to, and we can seek peace. When you start having the we, the second you get into that, then how are the we funded, and how do you get the resources?
I don't want to address them. I want the chaos to thrive. But the first time you give a trial, people, the judge is going to say, I don't work for free.
What trial?
But there's this,
why am I always going to have a trial?
The whole justice system
is going to be obsolete.
I'm looking for, to avoid this chaos, we have to have this thing that, you know, mushroom cloud.
How are you going to resolve the issue of somebody stole your stuff, and you say, hey, Larken stole my stuff, I want it back. Larken says, I didn't steal your stuff.
But the assumption you have when asking those questions, that's called the trial. The assumption you have whenever you're starting to ask the question of, you know, but what if this happens? How do we resolve this? You're presuming that somehow you know what the ultimate right thing is for those individuals in those situations.
I have no idea what the right thing is.
But the thing is, the accusation is
Larken stole your stuff.
Right.
When you say, I got to figure it out, that's what I call
a trial. But I got to figure it out. It's not a trial. But what is it then?
We're
going to
sit down with Larken and say, Larken,
did you steal
my stuff? Okay,
define this trial. What building is this trial?
Right, exactly.
Who are the people that have the shiny badges and the robes and the wigs?
I didn't say anything about shiny badges. It may look like an arbitration. We have private arbitrations now.
It's
perfectly fine.
Every individual is going to have their own goals for what they want out of the situation, and so every individual person isn't going to have this. There's not this single, you know, this is the absolutely correct way to handle this. There's what I want out of it. For me, it might not be worth it to pursue him, and so I go. You know what?
Okay.
You stole my stuff, and I can't get it back, and I don't care. And someone else might go, and someone else might say, you know what? No, I'm going to try and sneak into this place
and go through
his stuff and see if I can get it.
Right.
But the problem is to ask the, what do we do about that? The problem is that it presumes that you know for anyone else, or that we have to figure out for someone else.
If you say Larken stole my stuff and Larken says, no, I didn't.
So we deal with problems as they come. I choose not to pursue it any further.
I think that's the end of it.
Right, but we deal with problems as they come. Meaning that we don't, the idea of trying to know ahead of time how we're going to handle every problem doesn't make any sense.
But can we predict with certainty that we're going to get into
issues?
Can we predict with certainty that in a society there will be disputes about people violating the non-aggression principle?
Well, yeah.
He violated the non-aggression principle. No, I didn't. So how are we going to resolve those disputes?
Wait, keep asking that question.
The search for a final decider is the most destructively bad idea in the history of the world, and that's what you're talking about.
Yes.
That's why I don't like the term we. How will this magic thing determine... How will this magic thing... all together as a whole bunch of people with different evidence and different beliefs and different everything else, make one decision? The answer is don't make one fucking decision, because the moment you do that, everyone is throwing away their own responsibility to an authority. And the moment there is that, the authority will be the biggest violator around. Instead, be comfortable with the society where you will have disputes and there won't be resolution. Some will end badly, some will end good, people won't agree. There won't be a we deciding anything except to the point of equilibrium. I think what you did was wrong. He did something to you in response, and now we're all to the point where people just go...
disaffiliation.
Yeah, where people just go, oh, well, this is how it is.
I mean, you know, whatever.
And we can still disagree.
Right.
We didn't need to come to a conclusion. We didn't need to make a decision. But most importantly, nobody said, I'm acting on behalf of we. Because that's the end of civilization.
I don't think every person, it is.
Because if you don't feel personally justified on your own doing what you're doing, it means you think you have special rights because we told you to do something.
If I feel like I'm the victim of, let's just say, some horrible crime, then I'm accusing somebody of violating the non-aggression principle.
Yeah.
No problem so far, right?
Right.
Can't I say I want that resolved? I can say Larken violated the non-aggression principle as to me or my property.
Then Larken says, I
go to Larken and say, hey, man, I think you did this or that. You say no. Or better yet, you say, yes, I did, but I don't care.
So what's the point?
The point is that the end of it?
No, Twitter.
No. The end of it is whatever everybody in the world decides to do about it.
Maybe I sort of rallied the people in the community and say, hey, I think Larken committed a horrible crime, and he actually admitted to it and said he's going to continue to commit horrible crimes.
And maybe you get torches and pitchforks and kill me. The thing is...
Then you're president of the United States.
And so what I'm suggesting is, instead of us getting pitchforks and killing you, because that doesn't seem very civilized to me, maybe
good.
What we ought to do is appoint a private arbitrator and say, hey, why don't we take the dispute to the private arbitrator and let the private arbitrator conduct what I would call a trial, which is a really fair,
yeah.
best way we know to try to get
I'm
to
not
the
against
what
The
occurred.
One thing I'm against is the moment anybody acts who doesn't feel personally justified in what he's doing,
right.
who thinks he's acting on behalf of something else. The rules, the authority, the we, the collective
yes.
sent me here to do
yeah,
this.
So you have
if,
to sure you
like, whatever
okay
anybody decides,
whatever
if you're
do.
The one taking the guy's car and driving it into the lake,
but I don't
you
want
damn
to do
well.
That. I'm busy as an attorney. I want to hire somebody else to do it.
Good. Well, then whoever you hire.
I'm hiring Max.
Okay,
if
that's
Max
great.
Is
if
not,
he does
Max,
it,
but
he knows it's on him. It was his choice. It was his
that's
action.
Fine.
It was his
that's
responsibility.
Fine. But
he's not
going to
say,
I'm
acting on behalf of
the give Larken a trial.
So here's the thing.
Yeah, that's not the problem.
Of course there are going to be there'll be trials. I think your question is how
well,
these guys
know the justice system's going to be obsolete.
No, yeah,
none of that's
they're
going to use it a lot.
Exactly,
we're
exactly.
Then
we
have
but not in the we mentality.
But hang on,
right
listen. Here's the thing. I think the hang up for you is that you're not the law becomes a marketplace, just like price is set with supply and demand, and it's fluid. Law become there's now competition in law. There's competitive protection
absolutely.
Agencies, and there is fluidity over time with the law.
Right.
And I think that's what you're struggling with. No, I want certainty. I want price fixing.
I'm not struggling.
That's
with
what
that
you're asking
all.
For. It's
don't
a marketplace of the law.
We got to figure out what the law is.
Now, well, listen. There's,
so
for example, no one had to pass
advance.
A law. Maybe they did.
Well, but
example,
isn't
but
isn't,
no one
had, start, but isn't the non-aggression principle itself the law?
No,
it's not.
I think it's absolutely the law.
Wait.
It's absolutely the law.
No,
that's what we're,
it's not.
So,
wait.
If I initiate force against you, you're not going to complain about anything?
Here's
no, it's
the
not, no,
difference.
It's not about
that. What's the problem with me initiating force
it's
against
not
you?
A law. It's a description of what human beings already know and understand.
They don't.
That's
most
exactly.
people don't know and understand
no,
that. That's why we're
no,
in the minority.
Do. No, they do. Most people are anarchists most of the time. Look at how people live in everyday life. It's when government interrupts something or when a government agent interrupts someone is when coercion...
the guy
if you
who kills
the people,
potatoes
look
for
the
Nazis
who are
felt
actually,
like he didn't kill anybody.
Yeah, but look at the people
yeah.
who are actually causing most of the direct violence in the world that are actually stealing from people, the IRS, the police, the military. They are a tiny,
right,
tiny percentage of the world population.
You don't hold the people who
and,
support that stuff responsible
and,
for what they're doing?
No, they are voting and they're supporting it with their words.
In
but
their
in their
money.
Everyday actions, they're actually what they do every day when they wake up
so
and they
live
their life.
So they're not responsible for what the government has done at their behest.
They are indirectly supporting it. Absolutely.
Right.
Yeah,
yeah, but they are not. They are not in their actual.
That's where
actions.
The battle of public opinion.
Yeah.
Comes.
They, yeah. Exactly. They are.
And that's where this whole thing is coming. We have a good friend of ours.
Lives,
that's a federal judge right now.
I'm just simply
that
saying
was
if you want to have
a candidate for governor,
right.
John Butler.
There's nothing wrong with calling that the law. Don't
there
be
is.
What, let
there
me
is.
Make
no,
this no, point. Let me make this point.
Let Ernie do it, and I'll explain why that is the root of all.
John comes up and he goes to the Freedom Summit, and he's a federal judge now. He was a Superior Court judge, he's an attorney, a libertarian
about
candidate.
About
John Butler. John Butler, good guy. Well, he goes, you know, I don't see in the future that there is anything that you can legitimize as a profession as something that would exist without a government. Will there be judges without government? Probably.
Yeah.
Probably.
You know, you read Moon's a Harsh Mistress, man. You know, we agree on this guy to be our judge and we'll abide by the whatever.
You mean probably or absolutely without question there are going to have to be judges?
Well, I'm not going
to
be certain about anything, but I would imagine that probably
unless you're not certain about
if
we're going to have disputes. Unless you're not sure about whether we're going to have disputes about violations of the non-aggression principle.
I'm not going to count on anybody, you know, voluntarily agreeing to some third party to say what they want to do.
No, but I'm just saying it's naive.
It's probably likely.
It's just naive. I mean, it's utopian to think that people aren't going to intentionally violate the non-aggression principle.
But, no,
yeah.
but
no,
then
no,
what was the solution? You go
that.
To these judges and both
say,
agree
what?
And they both pay him.
No.
And then he's a good judge.
No, no, no,
if you
okay.
have
it's
coercion,
not like a, it's not like a maybe
I hate the idea
judge.
Of
there's
we are going to give you
maybe,
your judge that we have to use force and coercion and taxes and military and police to be able to go and put Larken in jail because he refused to pay for the judges.
Right.
It's going to happen. What's your point? Well, there's going to be
the point is we're going to need. Well, somebody had said the justice system is going to be obsolete.
Yeah, no, that's ridiculous. That's ridiculous and nonsense. I
the justice system is still going to exist, and it's going to have judges and defense lawyers and prosecutors and court reporters and all that stuff. We're going to have
not
going to
be funded by force.
How
are
we going to fund it?
The change. The change. The thing that matters.
By force, by the way.
That has not changed. You're still talking in the authoritarian mindset. The law is absolute fucking bullshit, and I will tell you why. 2 + 2 = 4 is not a law. It is a description of reality. Those are the only rules that matter. We decide that if you do X, we're justified to do that. Us writing it down on a piece of paper and calling it law is a bullshit ritual that adds nothing to the equation. It's just a description and a warning.
Of what it is.
If I say, if you break into my house, I'm going to punch you in the face, that's not a law. It's a threat. Threats are valid. Laws are bullshit.
Okay, but forget what you call it. You have to give people notice about
it.
What
matters what
is.
You call it, because to call it the law is to make it an authority.
I
don't call
it
a law that I'm going to punch you in the face if you come into my house.
No, but if you want to if you want to say the rule ought to be the non-aggression principle, that's not the rule everywhere.
No,
right
Mark's hang-up is the certainty.
That's the
forewarning. Your hang-up is
the forewarning is due process.
I know.
You have to tell people what
the
rule is.
Listen, that's a fantasy of perfection. We don't have a law for every possible conceivable situation.
I'm not suggesting that at all.
Why are you comparing it to that standard?
No, but you need
there will be some
you need
laws.
Some notice to.
There
for
will
example,
be.
The non-aggression principle is giving people
no,
notice.
No, but when,
if
when
you violate somebody's person or property, we're going to do things to you.
Here's the thing.
But that's
if you
a
violate
warning,
my property,
not a law.
So then I would like, okay, let me use your language. I would like a list of various warnings for people who come to the community. And here are the warnings. If you're accused of violating one of our warnings, we're going to bring you in.
Stop saying we. First of all, we don't ever do anything.
Who's going to do it?
A human being.
So the 90-year-old lady is going to hire a protection agency, and they're going to act in a... They're gonna
and
act
whoever
in a,
does
she
it is the human being doing it. He
it.
Is the one responsible for doing it.
Yes.
He never has the excuse of, I'm acting on behalf of we. That's
exactly.
always a bullshit excuse. If you aren't justified in doing it yourself, you shouldn't be frickin' doing it. And that's the problem with the law. The moment it becomes this magical, mystical, abstract thing that people
magical,
act
mystical.
On behalf of.
Why does it have to be magical, mystical?
Because
why can't
the law.
It just be notice about what the rules are?
Because then that's
it's
not
the warnings.
Law.
It's the
then that's not
it's
warnings.
The written, notice
it's warnings
the
fine.
Warning.
Threats fine. Nobody would ever call it the law if I said, if you break into my house, I'm going to shoot you. It's not a law. It's a warning. It's a threat. It's me saying what I already think is morally justified. It's not me legislating some new right into existence. It's me describing reality in the same way that 2 + 2 = 4. It's not a freaking law.
We're in another country. Acapulco, you go, and Mark's traveled quite a bit, and you go different places. And I'm always, you know, wondered, is there a universal cosmopolitan traveler guy that's not really a threat, you know, going anywhere? Does he know that there's a common basic, just don't be a jerk, okay?
Yeah.
You know, so, and I'm going, but you can go in some places and they don't have all the laws posted. You know, you stood on the wrong freaking corner for too long and man, shit happens.
Spit on the
so,
sidewalk.
You know, so how,
right?
so how do you know? Right. You know, the thing is that it's, I don't know, check the newspaper, look at the internet,
but,
you know, go
right,
call a travel agency
but
or something.
That it's not a perfect warning doesn't kill the entire idea that there should
no,
be warnings.
No, I'm saying
out
that
there.
When I interview people from all over the world and I'll say, they'll go, well, the law here and we changed it. I go, I don't give a crap. It's Chile, man. They change it every week. You know, New Zealand, we were talking about going to New Zealand in the early 2000s and then it just kind of started changing. Still pretty nice, but I mean,
just there.
You know stuff changes. Then, you know, Venezuela, Argentina, I mean, even Mexico. Hello, U.S. So I'm going, I don't ask what the law is. I go, what's the culture? What do the people say and do? Cambodia? Hell no, you can't go on the beach and doing this and that. But a lot of the guys, that go, hell yeah, you open up a bar, nobody gives a crap. Mm-hmm. It's the culture. So I don't look at the law. I look at the culture. And we are living in an anarchist planet with a bunch of little badges running around telling you what they want to enforce.
Exactly.
And I would much rather have people enforce it and with the attitude that they have responsibility for their own actions. And they always use this we in government and the shiny badge and the gun as an excuse for not thinking.
Exactly. Yeah. That's the cop does. Because the cop does that the minute he's beating somebody going, I don't make the laws, I just enforce them.
Right.
He's pretending that law really is this thing that once I wrote it down, once I breathed it into existence, this thing I thought, it suddenly became this God thing that now I can't change and I have to like serve it. And that's the problem with turning something into
right.
a law. If by law you mean something that now we just agreed on it, so now we have to follow it like it can never be changed, it can't mean something. But if it's just a description of this is what I think right now, it can change at any minute. And the good thing about that is every individual and every like in every situation is going to have a totally different reaction to what happened to them and how they want to handle it. And just like, and it all comes back to the violation of consent. So just like you said with homeowners associations going to a dangerous place, just like if I married my husband Tom and I said, you know, I want to marry you and I want to live with you. But does that mean that, you know, I married him and therefore he can just have sex with me whenever he wants and it's not rape if I say no? The minute I, well, just because someone declares that doesn't
make
that morally okay. But what I mean is, the minute I remove consent, I should be able to walk away and not be harmed and not have anything taken from me. If I can't do that, I'm being governed and I'm being violated. And when it's so, that same thing with a job. A job can have hierarchies and a corporation can have hierarchies, but I'm choosing to work for them. And it has consequences while I'm in that. But I can walk away the minute I don't like it. And if I cannot walk away from a homeowners association or freely say, you know what, I don't want to trim my weeds this week, and they're going to come and try to use force to take me from my home or something because I didn't pay them eventually, I didn't pay that citation because I didn't trim my weeds, that's, I'm being violated.
But did you agree in advance to trim your weeds?
You can agree in advance, but the problem we have is this huge sickness is everybody hallucinates somehow that you can actually agree to have your consent violated, and that's a logical impossibility.
But if
you can't agree ahead of time. So, for example,
but if you've truly agreed, your consent's not violated.
No, you can't. Exactly. But here's the thing. So it doesn't matter what I say ahead of time. If I come to a new moment where I change my mind, that has to be honored.
Unless you made an agreement in advance that you can't change your mind.
No, I didn't.
Well, so who are you to tell me I can't make this
agreement?
No, because here's why. My husband could rape me. If he comes to me,
why can't you consent to that?
Then it's not rape. By definition, if you consent, it's not rape. Listen, if I say to my husband right now, if I'm batshit crazy enough to say, you know, you can have sex with me whenever, and I don't care, and you can just do that. And then, let's say three months later, what if he pays you for it? What if he says,
I'll give you $100 for the privilege of having sex with you forever, whenever.
Let me make my point. If 3 months later, I say, absolutely not.
Then you're violating the agreement.
You're violating my contract.
No, that's my body, and I can say you don't get to do
that. It's actually kind of an interesting argument.
Yeah, see, this argument has always been, can you sell yourself into slavery?
You can't sell yourself into slavery.
And libertarians actually disagree. This is a great example of what I've been saying. This is one of the many things that libertarians don't quite agree to. Some libertarians will say you can sell yourself into slavery, and if you run away, let's just say he wants to purchase you for $500,000, and in exchange he's gonna give that money to your kids so they can go to college or whatever. You say fine, and 5 years down the road you've decided I don't want to be a slave anymore. One libertarian might say, when you try to run off of his plantation, you're picked up and returned because you violated the rules. Another libertarian might say, which is you, that there are certain rights that I can't alienate from. My body is actually one of
you
those
can.
Rights.
Yeah.
That's your position on it. Right. This is a great example of what I'm saying. Which one are we going to enforce?
Neither. Both.
Neither.
There isn't going to be a way.
There
doesn't
need to
be a way.
But here's the problem. When Ryan is from,
we'll call the old school libertarian. When Ryan says, hey, she made a deal, and she can't renege on that deal, and she's seeking shelter at my house, right?
And as an individual, responsible human being, we'll decide what to do, and we have nothing to do with it.
Say we've had this problem. Now we've had
no,
this problem.
No, say you have this problem.
We don't have anything.
Fine.
But now
I suggest, hey, next time, it makes sense to serve notice. So when you enter into these kinds of contracts,
we'll know in advance whether or not you can alienate your body.
No, it's not like that. It's a ranking system. It's eBay for people. You trust this person to keep a contract or you don't.
What's so horrible? Here's what I'm saying. What's so horrible about us getting together and saying, here's what we're going to enforce for rules. We, together, yeah, we're going to make laws. We're going to write warnings, and we're going to say...
Who's going to force them? You, individually?
Our protection. We're going to hire a protection organization that's either going to enforce the notion that he owns her or that she can't alienate her body.
And I'm the women's suffrage movement of the anti.
Going forward, we're going forward,
and if someone decides
whether or not
I'm not
he can engage
mind,
into that kind of a contract, that's so horrible.
You don't object to that taking place, do you? You don't object to that.
Which one?
But the example you just said, like, you don't object to people organizing and saying.
Right, if it's voluntary, no. What I object to is the notion that we need a final decider, which is the most dangerous lie in the history of the world.
Our protection company's going to be the final decider.
No, they won't.
Someone's going to
decide. Because they're not bulletproof. Other people can decide to
shoot them.
Exactly.
We don't.
I think this takes it to the next step where it solves the problem. And this kind of challenges you on the we thing as well.
Okay.
It's okay. The example is we subscribe to give some warning and follow through on some threat.
Okay.
Someone comes here and steals, we're going to go and kidnap you and give you the death penalty, whatever it is. Okay. All right?
And we each...
We employ me to go and kill him.
Yes.
And we each...
Now,
I want to clarify something about what you said. So you're saying every one of us said we think this is a joke.
You voluntarily paid me to go and do it.
Yeah.
And we all agree with it.
And we all agree with it. If this happens, Max, I want you to go and kill someone who comes and steals something.
Star Chamber.
Okay. With that. Now, I go and do that, right? I know, this is going to satisfy your two things, I think. I know that if he has a bigger, more powerful group behind him saying that's unacceptable, I'm going to get beat down.
Right.
Right.
But and maybe you too.
I'm acting as I'm acting.
We're
going to
back
we.
Him because we've decided.
So that's
it's
the challenge
okay
on we. I am acting for we.
Yeah.
But I'm going to get my ass kicked by the bigger, badder group.
No, you're going to wear an executioner hood and carry the axe.
We're
going to know
we're
going to
back
is.
Him. We're going to jointly.
You're
going to
back
him.
There's a big group of people over there backing that guy, and there's a big group of people over here backing this guy. And your question is, how do we solve that problem?
Well, we're going to. This is international relations.
You're still looking for a final
decision. No, I'm not. I'm saying. The market will solve it.
Because it's always mythical and it's always destructive.
What if
the market will solve
asking,
it in that. That big group of people is going to have a war with us or this group of people, and we're going to say,
or we'll
this
negotiate
sucks.
Something and
someone
resolve.
Bribes someone to
economically,
get out of it.
Economically, what's going to happen will happen.
It's going
to
be a hell of a lot better than fighting a war.
You don't need to appoint an emperor who will decide for all of us.
Well, and that's the part that I think that you're missing. Is that what part of that did not were you not comfortable with? That big group of people and this big group of people.
That's not. I have no problem with that.
They voluntarily joined there. We voluntarily joined here.
No problem with that.
It's now time to pay for the person to go and fight, and you go.
I've got no.
I don't really want to kill
this. No issue with any of that.
Then that's how it's going to
work. All I'm saying is, what we've decided is when she enters into the slavery contract with you. She knows in advance what we're going to enforce here in our group, and so do you, because it's going to affect the price, right? No, if she decides she could get out of it at any time, you're going to pay a lot less.
See, what
right?
you're
she
talking to... about happens in real life right now. I'll give you an example.
Yes, it does.
You have, how the hell did our oil get underneath their sand, okay?
We got to resolve that.
So then
we have
oil company, whatever the heck, goes up and says, and I signed a contract, and we did.
What,
and I ain't no we nothing. It's just
are.
A company
we've
that wants to do it. So then these guys over there, they go, no, we don't like it.
Have to do
well, we do, and so
the answer is it depends.
And I'm going
on the
if Exxon. Let me finish. If the Exxon Valdez had its own 16-inch guns, and Texaco had its own submarines, let them deal with it, and I don't got to pay for it. And there's no we.
So here's what.
Every time you create a we, it's a thermonuclear exchange. I'm just like, how about not? If you want to do it that bad, you look at the price of oil, and I looked at it one time, and all the wars and everything, it was $130 a barrel over the cost of the oil to get cheap oil. And I'm going, who the hell we would do that? We wouldn't do that. Neither would they if they didn't have we money to do it.
And none of the trigger fingers would have been there if they knew they were responsible for their actions. They're all, I'm just following orders.
See, it's a sickness.
And
no,
that's
what
we
happens
lead
with this
to, is I'm following
orders. No,
the
you're trying to, this is a straw man. You're trying to build an argument where there are no we's. And so you choose an example where we would not want to do it.
There you go.
But you would want to choose some examples where you would want to do it. For example, you would say, hey, I want to live in a world where if someone kills me, that there's some retribution, they get punished. Mm-hmm. That's going to encourage people not to kill me.
Right.
So, hey guys, let's get together. If anyone kills anyone of us, we all get together and say, let's go and get them. We now have a we. And you guys are trying to say there are no we's because of some example where we's wouldn't get together.
No, but
what
it's,
about
no,
examples
no,
where
it's
the
a different kind of we.
It's a different kind
a
of
we. The word we, the only rational moral use of the word we is a term that describes a collection of individuals. The we doesn't have any rights. The we doesn't have any decisions.
Right, right.
You can say we decided X. It means he decided X, he decided X, he decided. The shorter way to say it is we decided X. But we don't ever have any authority that has anything to do with anything other than every individual doing what he believes he has the moral
right
to
do. And you have groups of people will abandon a group because the we made a decision to go do something they don't agree with, and they publicly announce, I'm not part of the we on this. I didn't have anything to do with that. I'm over here.
But also
you know?
Understand, we're still going to impose our rules on other people, even if they don't like it. And let me give you an example.
Good question.
Yeah.
We, government. Your we, everybody unanimously has agreed that the following violations of the non-initiation of force principle will be dealt with in the following manner. Mm-hmm. We've made that decision. We've all agreed unanimously. Somebody else now jumps into our community. Cousin so-and-so has his brother Jeb over. Just call him Jeb. Jeb comes over and fucks
the
a
smartest
five,
one.
Jeb comes over and fucks a five-year-old girl. And we've decided that you don't get to fuck five-year-old girls. And when you fuck five-year-old girls, here's what we are going to do to you.
Well, wait. We don't do it.
We've decided
I'll do
that
it.
In advance. No, but
we don't shoot
we
a gun.
We hired Max. We're sending Max.
Yeah, you can do it if
we,
you like it.
No, but we've all agreed in advance that you don't get to fuck a five-year-old girl. And if somebody does, we're sending Max, and Max is going to do the following things. He's going to get a trial, and if we find him guilty, he's going to do this, that, and the next.
Okay.
We've agreed. Now, when Jeb comes in, Jeb says, well, in my community of hillbillies.
Why is he Southern?
He's Southern Australia.
Oh, okay.
So
Jeb, like that,
so Jeb says, in my community, we've decided that five-year-old girls like to be fucked, and it's just par for the course.
I don't
so,
care about their
so,
weight.
So hold on. I don't agree to what you guys have decided. So leave me alone, Max.
You better get what a bigger gun and a bigger
what
weed.
Right, so what I'm going to say is, what I'm going to say here is, sorry, Jeb, we have decided... The Larken Rolls, we have decided that we're going to treat you in the following manner, even if you don't like it.
Yeah.
Now, all I'm shooting back to you is this. You can't try to shoehorn this into the current world we have, where the people who want the non-initiation of force principle are in the minority, because it's never going to work. What you're going to get is Mark Skousen's world about today's eminent domain, tomorrow it's quarantines because
right.
you had a cold, the next day it's we've decided this and that. It's a different world. In a world where you got Butler Schaefer and Larken Rose and everybody else, we can probably do a pretty decent job. And if we don't,
right.
then someone else in another community does a better job. And we have a marketplace of freedoms, and we just move over
but
there.
But the difference will be whoever goes after that guy, whether you hired him, whether somebody just pissed
Max
off, whoever it is, we'll make him be the guy.
Jeb's boys
he
may be coming for Max.
In
yeah,
a free society
yeah.
that has given up authoritarian, you know, mythology, never for a moment will he think, I don't think this is justified, but I'm going to do it on behalf of them, and that makes it okay.
He's only going
right.
to take
he,
the job if he agrees
basically,
with the principles.
I know.
Exactly.
Or maybe not.
Right.
Maybe not.
Then all it would be is one person saying, I think this is justified, and a bunch of other people saying, we think that too. But we don't have a fucking thing to do with it, except he knows we're
more
not going to do anything.
More than that. When I go and do it, and his guy's defense organization
yes.
comes after me,
right.
you guys will
yes.
fund my defense.
Yeah.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
And
yeah.
that's the critical step. So
critical.
But I don't get what's hard with it. Like, why do you have a challenge with it? That's what's going to happen.
That's
you
what
guys,
happens.
You guys are committing.
Already,
you guys
it's
are committing
right.
to defend
okay, so
me.
So all I'm saying is this. To the Jebs of the world, when you come here, you don't get to fuck five-year-old girls.
Yeah, warning.
And we're going to write it down. Larken
warning.
Wants to call this a warning.
Threat.
Marc wants to call it a law. But
yeah,
Marc likes Larken, so we won't call it. Here's the warning, everybody. Don't
but
fuck five-year-old girls.
The reason to not call it a law
yeah.
is the word law.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Semantics. I can't
imagine.
It's
not semantics.
You,
it is absolutely
yeah, you go to Afghanistan.
Term.
I don't think they got a lot of written laws. I think they just, you do stuff, stuff happens. You know?
As a practical matter.
Law didn't used to be an authoritarian term. It used to refer.
It is authority. It's us deciding.
Wait,
in our community,
wait.
This is what we're going to do to five-year, the people
who
fuck
five-year-olds.
That's
not an authority.
That's
describing what you're going to do if somebody attacks someone.
Yeah,
that's
no,
it.
It's
not
authority.
Authority.
It's
but
like saying the state.
Is,
it's like saying dude. The state. The state's an illusion. And like I've said, when the state grabs you and throws you in a cage, the illusion seems kind of real.
The authority
no,
isn't.
The
violence
the authority
is
absolutely. The violence
yes.
is real.
The violence
the,
is real.
The coercion is real.
To call it law, that implies authority. It implies that that thing is something instead. It's the 2 plus 2 equals 4.
All right,
it's
I would
no
like
law.
To,
that's just a description of reality.
Right, so, I think we beat that horse to death.
Yeah,
I think
we
beat it
I'm
down.
Sort of satisfied we don't have much of a disagreement here. Other than maybe semantics. What you want to call a warning, I'll call a law.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, we're still going to give the guy a fair trial.
Yeah,
we're going
to
pay for it still needs to be worked out.
No, I'm just like, it's just fun. No, I'm just enjoying the fact that you love trying to find disagreements if there aren't any.
I do. Absolutely love it. Well, I like to know if I'm dealing with a real freedom person or a fake freedom person. That's how I feel about
it. I think Larken's pretty fake.
No, but I have to give props for that because that's a good way to go about it. It's just amusing to watch because most people are emotionally trying to, they're disagreeing with something because they have a real emotion attached to something they really totally think and they're attached to it. And you're just like, I just want to.
What's wonderful about this, but let's just try.
What
I would love to see happen is different communities trying hard to do a good job at realizing the non-aggression principle and see what they come up with. And really, what's going to happen? This is what would happen. Our little community is going to come up with a set of warnings, and that little community is going to come up with a set of warnings, and so is that, and so is this, and they may have a better set of warnings than us, and they may work out, we're going to say, yeah, maybe we should adopt that set of warnings, and we're going to probably merge in or do something else, and that's fine. That was the whole point of my comment.
But that's not going to happen
right.
if you have the concept of a government or somebody or collectively.
Forget what you call it.
No, I tell you, I talked to, you know, we come down to Acapulco last year and I talking to Berwick and he's really pushing for people to come down and Angela Clark, you know, is here and so on. And I go like, Angel Clark. Right?
Clark.
So I go, Angel, I said, well, what's it like down there? How'd it go? She just moved. She left from Northeast America. She said, boom, peace out and said goodbye family and didn't want the government. And boom, she's here. Okay. So I'm going, how is it to deal with these governments? You know, the police, I talked to the taxi drivers last year, and I was asking because then they were burning the presidential palace. So that tells you everything you know right there. So I'm going, you know, I'm going, really, on the news, you're down in Acapulco, and the people are, you know, protesting in the streets. Well, they had some military, the feds here. So I go and I ask the taxi drivers, and I'm going, yeah, well, you think, oh, yeah, it's great that they're here. I go, why? Because the local Acapulco police are so freaking corrupt that they prefer the federales being here over the damn, they got the helicopters and the ship out here. And so bring them on, man, these damn
well,
cops.
Walter
so my point. So my point is this. I go, what's the culture? How do you deal with when you do a remodeling on a home? Where do you build? Who are they calling? If it's, it doesn't matter what your warning of the law is, it's a political decision of somebody with the money goes to some bureaucrat and says, we don't like that guy. This guy is interfering too much. That gringo doesn't need to blah, blah, blah. So your rules don't mean squat. It is selectively enforced as it is. How many times have you been in a case of selective enforced of whatever? Yep. So I'm going, this is what I don't like. And we kind of just, you know, give ourselves over this concept of government and law. And I would much rather have a culture. There is no shiny badge. There may be a thug. There may be a bad guy. I just got done watching the Godfather series again. Godfather 2, you know, it has where, hey, you know, I'm a nice guy. I take care of, we got rid of the bad guys. They know who to go for. You don't get justice from him, they go to someone else and that guy's dead.
So let me ask
you. Know, so I'm just looking, this law that you're talking about and this government
warning,
that's inevitable.
Man. We call them warnings.
Well, these warnings,
around, we call
these
them warnings.
Warnings don't mean
you've
anything
been charged with
because they
the
selectively
warnings.
Enforce whatever they want
that,
based
man.
On political decisions or who they like or don't like or how tall you are or how gay you are.
I want to ask these two guys.
So
right.
I'm looking
the
at the culture
the
and that is not going to happen
right.
as long as we have this sickness. When you eliminate all that, will you still have fiefdoms in this neighborhood versus that neighborhood? Of course you will.
It would be nice to see people trying to get the non-aggression principle and get it
and that
right.
would be the
that
most
be
popular neighborhood, I would hope.
But I'm just curious what the two of you think about this. And you didn't hear my talk, but you did you hear my talk? I raised this in a second. I was running out of time. But this issue of a substantial risk of an imminent trespass is a dangerous, slippery slope, and one I think you got to deal with.
Yeah,
this
like
notion
where
of,
do you draw
like
the line?
The drunk guy with the automatic 50 who wants to celebrate New Year's.
Yeah.
Hey, man, I'm getting ready. Do we get? Is it appropriate? Let me just not a law question. Is it appropriate?
I'm going to complain about we again. You decide what you're going to do about it.
Okay,
I decide what I'm going to do about it.
I'll tell you what I would
like. Is it your lawn?
My question stay inside at midnight.
It's not up to me.
What is Larken going to do?
At some point, flying tackle.
But at which point? At the point at which he's...
It's almost impossible to exactly define it. And it's impossible
to... Here's what he says back to you in a drunk, alcohol... Infested kind of,
stupor,
yeah.
Right?
Here's what he says back to you. He says, hey man, we both like the non-aggression principle. I haven't initiated force on anybody. I'm standing in my yard. I'm not trespassing on anybody. Leave me alone. Why are you
You're endangering everyone. Is he shooting the gun in the air, just to be
He's
clear?
He's getting ready to.
Okay. Yeah, and that's the thing is there is no way to define to write down a rule that determines the exact line. Like an example I use is somebody calls me up and says, I'm going to come kill you. He gets in his car. He drives over here. Like at what point do I have the right to decide?
Okay, so here's what I would say when we get our libertarian revolution and we're in our small community, I'm going to say, hey, Larken, I propose a warning.
And that revolution
The
right
warning
here.
Ought to be the following.
Yes.
You are not to initiate force or fraud against anybody at any time. And if you do, we're sending Max after you. And in addition to that, if you do something, we're not going to tell you what it is yet because we don't know, but if you start an issue, if you create a substantial risk of an imminent force or fraud on somebody.
Endangerment,
We're also going to, we're sending Max and he's going to stop you before you've even done it.
Yeah, or we'll do it ourselves because we all feel, even if we're not
all
able to.
But I'm busy in court and you're writing books or whatever. We don't.
Yeah, but if I'm there and the guy's waving the gun around, I'm not waiting to call him.
Well, fuck it, Max gets shot, man. We're not going to get shot on this shit. That's why we're paying
the fucker. Okay, you're going to call him. I'm going to tackle the guy. But we all would feel justified even if we don't particularly
want to. No, but this is actually a libertarian, more of a, I'd call a libertarian philosophy question, because we're arguing in my group about whether or not, and here's why I worry about this, because Dianne Feinstein is going to say, oh, when somebody has a handgun in their house, that person is creating a substantial risk. And my response back has been, I'm not talking about how Dianne Feinstein's going to interpret this because we're never going to get freedom in that world. I'm talking about how people who are honestly and genuinely committed to effectuating the non-aggression principle, how are they going to react to it? And I think we're exactly, all three of us, I think, are exactly on point, or are you not on point?
I think the previous thing that we could have talked about for an hour but didn't really get an answer to answers this question. And the how would I handle that situation? I would choose to live in a HOA where that kind of shit is not allowed.
But people
still
do it.
Whatever they and then they've got these issues that Larken's talking about. You got to be the guy who goes and fucking tackles the guy with the
drunk
handgun.
If there's no time, I'm going to tackle him. If there is time, he's probably not an imminent risk anyway.
I am choosing to give up many, lots of liberties, like, can I be drunk and shoot shit in the air in my front yard? I am willing to give up.
Well, you don't have the liberty to shoot rounds down someone else's property.
No, but I can go straight up, right? In a drunken stupor, I can do it. This is your hypothetical,
yes,
right?
Yes, of course.
I choose to give up that liberty for the safety of knowing that no one else, should anybody else around me try to do that, I can call someone who's going to come and kick their ass.
Wouldn't it be fun if we get to a point where we're actually arguing about effectuating the non-aggression principle and how it could possibly work?
Like if this was the problem with society, this was the toughest thing.
See,
here's the thing with the non-aggression principle. It's not magic, and we're certainly
not
going for
a
world whereby there is no aggression, and if there is, you have to respond with it. Because of all of these little fringe cases that you're talking about, of which there's millions. It's a guiding principle which says you don't set up your society built on government, which means the whole thing is corrupt.
Well, I wouldn't even
beginning.
Say that. You don't set up your society based on a notion that it's okay to initiate force against non-aggressors.
Okay.
That's where we are now.
But we all agree.
The announcement.
But we all agree. We can come up with some hypothetical, if this isn't your flavor, that some guy drunk and erratically, whatever, shooting his thing, is whatever. At some point, you're going to go and tackle him.
Yes. No problem.
Yeah.
We're not sending Max after you if you do that.
I would just argue there may be this small group of people who are like, I don't want to give up any freedom.
Yep.
That I want the freedom to do anything I want.
Absolutely.
And they're all living somewhere. And
but if they come into our HOA and they violate what we unanimously have agreed over the warnings,
taking them down to
Max
town.
Goes after them.
And this is the marketplace of ideas. No, we like no one had to. There wasn't a law for us to communicate with each other through language. Just the market decided this word meant that, this word meant that.
Let me just finish this one thought, and then listen to my friend Alessandro who's coming up. This is where we differ with Marc Skousen. Because Marc, I'm okay with Marc Skousen loving his homeowners association. I'm okay
I love it.
I'm okay with him joining the Socialist Homeowners Association, whatever homeowners association he wants to join.
Sure, he'd love that.
Where I'm not okay where, and he can work at it, go to his church, and all those things that he likes to do, that's fine. That's all peaceful, and that fits within what I think makes sense. But where I'm not okay is when he now decides he wants to initiate for us with eminent domain. Right, he's decided he's coming over here and he's taking Larkin's house because it's not convenient that Larken lives
right.
where he'd like to put a road.
And the answer to that is this: can he, with enough people, raise enough money to come and fight Hugo with enough money
now.
And whatever? Then you lose. That's
Except
the answer.
That's only because people believe in authority. If he,
exactly.
as a person, said, "I want Larken's property." I say, well, I have an AR-15, and I don't want to give you my property. And everybody around me is going to say, well, we don't want to give you our property,
right,
and if we
enough.
Let you take his.
Right now he's got enough people because might makes reality.
Because
right
of
now.
State, not because of might, because
right,
of belief
not
in authority.
Because of might, because of the state,
because
enough people
because
believe in
most
him.
Of the country might say, that sucks,
but
the
state
it's
has
the law.
The might. If the state didn't have the might, we wouldn't worry about it, right?
I know, but they only
they
have
don't.
The might because
the
they're
tiny
perceived
dog.
To have the authority.
And they have the money. And they have the money to pay for it because they had the right to steal your money to attack yourself.
And because
right.
now, but all this means is that
it's
the market will move. It's just the market will move. We don't know how far it's going to move to. It will move towards freedom, but it won't be absolute freedom because then you end up with dickheads.
Yeah,
well,
free market's
going to
move away from central
what
planning
really
and everything,
about is trying
including
trying to move the market
currency.
In freedom in that direction. We're trying to win more hearts and minds, and that's always what mm-hmm. it comes down to. When we win enough, mm-hmm. we're good.
I want to talk about the HOA thing. This is for me the most interesting part. I really want to hear this. The stepping stone argument. HOA is moral and fine. If you want to go and join HOA, you can. Stepping stone to where HOA becomes a country. And they're
mm-hmm. It's not real consent. We've already covered that. It's not a true consent.
What is not a true consent?
When you say to Larken, hey, you're in the United States, it's like saying to the Jews, you live in Nazi Germany. Hey, it's a big homeowners association here. You've agreed to go to the ovens. They didn't really agree to that. They didn't
right,
really agree. When she goes
right.
into her homeowners association, they say, "Hey, you know, you got to plant your grass, and if you don't plant your grass, we're gonna charge you, and we're gonna do your."
When Skolson said social contract, I had to.
Yes,
but
it's real consent, and again, this is something.
So what's your definition of consent?
This is one of
this,
those.
This goes back to the changing rules.
This is
rules
one
afterwards.
Of those many
yeah.
areas. No, this is one of those many areas, right? For example, her and her husband. He says she consented to having sex with me. She says, I said no. We've put a warning up there. If you have sex with somebody without their consent, we're sending Max.
Correct.
We're going to have the judge, the court, the everybody, they're going to sit and listen to the evidence and make a determination at some point whether her consent was valid or not valid.
Our homeowner association, if you get married, man, you're putting
no,
it out.
No, but consent is one of those many issues. It's one of those many issues you're not going to get a bright line rule on.
Yeah.
People
yeah.
have limited capacity on things. What about when I enter into a contract and we find out their IQ was, you know, something along the lines of...
Your argument applies both to HOAs and countries.
Yes,
I want to
everything.
Know where, no, where does the line change where a HOA, the rules that apply to HOAs do not apply? Like, if I can go and voluntarily enter into this thing whereby I say, okay, rather than pay, you know, $1,000 a year for my to be part of this community, I want to pay 50% of my income taxes. Okay, that sounds reasonable. Like, that's stupid, but it's still
voluntary.
Not
necessarily
stupid.
Right.
Stupid, but
it's
voluntary.
It's no more
okay,
stupid
cool.
than the socialist who buys into the social. It's his
okay.
thing.
You, right. So inch
well,
forward. When
yes, we respect the rights of stupid people
right.
to be stupid as long as they're peaceful.
So
right.
how do you defend
exactly.
against the argument that you live in an anarchist world, doofus?
It
just this is what
the
market
the
chose.
The
a
only,
really big HOA
only,
called USA,
Max,
a really big HOA called Russia.
Is it wasn't real consent.
Because
it's
it was based on indoctrination. It wasn't based on people understanding what's going on.
You might
it.
Say
and
it was brainwashing,
yeah.
and
yeah.
therefore it wasn't
yeah.
real consent.
Yeah.
I would say
yep.
nobody actually asked you. It's like the Constitution.
Yeah, which is also
yeah.
true.
You
yeah.
can agree to live by the Constitution and let the people in the Supreme Court decide, but you got to actually agree to
with
that.
The inheritance, yeah. With the inheritance argument, if I join this HOA, I bought the land, I die, it goes to my child, he still has to abide by the HOA rules. He can sell the property and move
well,
out.
Actually,
now
it's
the,
a great point.
Now, the point, it's really, really easy
it's
for him
a
to do it because
about,
he has to move like 3 miles to
a
different
a
HOA.
About.
But when it's a country of, you know, the size of the USA, now of us, and all of the HOA, all of the other countries have shitty rules. Like, there's no free place.
Let me answer the... I understand the question.
But that's just a market failure
like,
as opposed to a point of principle where a HOA is,
well,
is moral and
the
countries
again,
are not.
The first speaker of the entire conference said something that was wrong. He said, all law is contract law. That's not true. Contract law is contract law. Property law is property law. Tort law is tort law. Criminal law is criminal law. Your question is, do we treat here's how I put your question in the legal realm. Do we treat restrictive covenants as contract law? In other words, doesn't bind your kid because he wasn't party to the deal, or do we treat them as property law, which is this is a deal that runs with the land? This is a great example of something that we get together and we say, how are we going to treat a restrictive covenant? Are we going to treat it as something that runs with the land so his kid automatically inherits and is stuck with that restriction? Or do we say the kid says, hey, I never contracted as part of this deal. I could paint my house any color I want. Yeah. There's no libertarian answer to that. But all I'm suggesting in all of this is we should figure out what the rule is. So people know when they put a restrictive covenant on the property, is it going to affect Max's kid or not? Because when Ernie buys in, Ernie wants to know if your kid is going to be subject.
So I think what will happen was
there's no problem.
The community,
with that.
Everyone who's paying their money, $1,000 a year to make sure the grass is cut and there's no potholes, they're all paying in. Someone dies, goes to their kid, the kid stops paying. They're like, okay, Let's go and extract the money from him, gang.
Well, no, this happens in Arizona right now. It's called Sun City.
If it runs
okay.
with the land, it's reasonable. If it's a contract, and all I'm saying is we got to use a Larken warning on this. We got to say, here's the warning. When you make a deal like this, it runs with the land, i.e. Max's kid's going to be subject, or it doesn't. It's contract law, and Max's kid's going to be out. He's a
generator.
I don't particularly care what gets decided and what people do. I care way more about the approach they have, whether it's authoritarian going in, like, well, we just decided to change the rules, and you're stuck with it because we're the we speak on behalf of we. Like, it could go either way in what you just said, as long as people know about it ahead of time.
Yes.
And
this is why I'm suggesting they got to be public. See, because
yeah,
the issue
I'm all
is,
for publicizing
the warnings.
The warnings
need to be
informing people.
So the issue
and
is really this:
people.
What does your kid inherit? Does he inherit the bundle of property sticks without the stick to paint the house purple, or
right.
does he inherit all of the sticks to do whatever the fuck he wants? There's no libertarian answer there.
Right.